Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to take a look at a particular type of acids and bases. Now, we know that there are two types of acids. There are binary acids and oxyacids. And we know how to identify bases. Now, just realize that there are going to be three types of categories for acids and bases. The first one being Arrhenius. Now, we're going to say the most general definition for acids and bases was developed by Arrhenius near the end of the 19th century. Now we're going to say, according to him, we're going to say that the H+ cation and the OH- anion were the fundamental pieces that helped to identify acids and bases. But the thing with him is, his failed to describe what happens to acids and bases when we take them out of water. When we take them out of aqueous solutions, what happens? His definition failed to talk about that. Now we're going to say, according to his Arrhenius definition, it states that an acid is a compound that increases my concentration of H+ when dissolved in a solvent, the solvent being water. Because to him, acids and bases only operated in aqueous environments, water. So we're basically going to say an example of an Arrhenius acid is HCl. When it breaks down in water, it's going to give me H+ plus Cl-. Now, his Arrhenius definition for an acid applies to both strong and weak acids, because if they can produce H+, then they're technically Arrhenius. Now, so the limitation here is that, to him, if you didn't have an H involved, you couldn't be an acid. But we'll learn later that this is just the wrong way of looking at things. Okay? So now that we know the definition for an acid, let's look at the definition for a base. We're going to say, according to his definition, Arrhenius' definition, a base is a compound that increases the concentration of OH- when dissolved in a solvent. Now what we're going to say here is, good example, we have NaOH. When it dissolves in water, it gives me Na+ plus OH-. If it didn't create any OH- as a product, then it couldn't be described as an Arrhenius base. Again, this definition is the broadest of the three definitions we're going to see. It was the earliest one developed. That's why it's so broad. It's basically any compound with H+ or OH-. We'll learn more and more definitions that are more precise to exactly what acids and bases are. Now that we've seen this, I want you guys to attempt to do these questions. You guys have to tell me, how do each of these compounds break up to give me my products? And based on the products, are they Arrhenius bases, Arrhenius acids, or maybe neither one? Good luck on the first one, guys. And again, once you're done with it, come back, click on the explanation button, and watch a video of me explaining how to break it up and what exactly is it that we're breaking up.